Hello everyone, in this video we are going to see about shared access signature, which is simply called as SAS. If you are new to our channel, please click on subscribe. Even your single subscription will motivate us to produce more video in better quality. Shared access signature is used to provide secure delegated access to the resources in your storage account. So let's consider the scenario. You are having a storage account for your application and you want the third party vendor to upload some kind of documents or some images to your storage blob. Normally, in order to upload a file into our blob, we will use the connection string which is available under access keys. But in case if we provide access keys of our storage account, then the third party vendor will able to access files, queues and table which is available in our storage account, which is not acceptable. The third party vendor is supposed to access only our blob. So in that case, we can go for shared access signature. For any untrusted clients, use a shared access signature. A SAS is a string that contains a security token attached to a URI. Using the shared access signature, you can decide whether you can provide read access, write access, even delete access. You can specify the time range of access. You can provide access for 1 year or 6 months. It's up to you. These are just overview to give an idea on what is SAS and where we need to use it. Before generating shared access token, you should aware that there is no way to audit the generation of SAS token. So any of your team member or your organization can generate the token and there is no way to check who had provided token and how many tokens is issued so far. So if you are not going to use shared access signature, then better disable the generation of shared access token. If you find your shared access signature is leaked or someone is misused, then you can disable the access to your storage account via SAS token. That steps will be provided at the end of the video. Now let's see how we can generate a SAS token. This is the storage account we have created from our last video and the URL is available in the video description. In case if you want, you can watch it. And under access keys, we will have the connection string which we normally use. Now let's see how we can generate a shared access signature. So just click on this shared access signature. So here only we will provide service level access, whether to blob or file, to queues, to what we need to provide the access, that we will provide from here. So you can select, and here we provide whether it is service level, container level or object level. And here you can provide read access, write access or delete. So whatever you want to select, you can check from here. And you can provide the end time of your token, so after which the token will expire. You can provide IP range, that will come as an additional security measure. And you can select whether you want to allow HTTP or HTTPS. Just click on generate SAS. And here you will find the connection string and the SAS token. Since we have selected blob at the top, we are now seeing only blob SAS token over here. In case we selected queues and tables, respective SAS token will be available below. We can even generate our SAS token at the container level. Let me show how. So go to the Storage Explorer, right click your container and click on get shared access signature. In case if you want to generate shared access signature at the file level, you can do so. Let me show how. Select your file and just click on shared access signature. Let's try to generate a shared access signature at the container level and I will show how we can use in Azure Data Factory. So right click our container and click on shared access signature. So here specify the start time and the expiry date. So you can specify any expiry date, a year or some months you can specify. And here provide read, write or whatever access you want to provide, just check and click on create. And you will have URI and the query string. Both of them is required in order to access it. So this is the Azure Data Factory we have created from our last video. This is just to show how we can consume shared access signature. In case if you are interested to learn Azure Data Factory, the playlist URL is available in the video description. So in Azure Data Factory, just click on this drop down. So we are in service link. Under service link, just select the SaaS URI and provide the SaaS URI from here. Copy the URI part from here and paste it in this text box. And for SaaS token, just go to the SaaS token and copy the query string from here and paste it. Yeah, done. Let's try to test the connection. Just click on test connection. Yeah, connection is successful. So we have seen how to generate SaaS token and we have seen how to consume it. Suppose if SaaS token is compromised, let me show how we can disable access to your storage account from SaaS. So under settings, just scroll down below, you will have settings. Yeah, this is the one. Under settings, you will have configuration. Under configuration, you will have an option called allow storage account key access. If you disable it, then whatever the SaaS token generated so far will not be able to access the storage account. And just click on save from the top. And let me show another option from here. Just scroll down. Here you can set upper limit for your shared access signature. So after which your SaaS token will be expired. So you can specify the number of days you want and just click on save. And that's it on this video. I have posted more videos on Azure Cloud Computing, Azure DevOps, Azure Data Factory and Git. Those playlist URL is available in the video description. And thank you for watching this video and I request you to subscribe my channel. Bye-bye.